I'm going to be using one of the whiteboard journals available from That's Crafty. They come in two square sizes. They come in the 6x6, which this is, and an 8x8 size. They all come with two outer covers and five inner tabbed pages, which line up inside your covers. I'm going to be working on the grey side of one of the tabbed pages with my Gelli Plate on this video. I thought I'd work on the grey side to show that you don't need gesso or anything to prep your page with when you use it. I have already done the other side of this, so when I'm pushing it down, you'll see the white side that I'd previously done with my Gelli Plate a few minutes ago. For the first layer, I'm going to apply the colour directly onto my Gelli Plate. I'm going to go for a strong colour, which is the turquoise, and then just a secondary colour, the cream. And I'll just lightly mix these on the plate to get a mottled effect. And I'm going to get my page and push the grey side down onto the plate to pick up the paint. And as you can see, that's covered the grey side really well. I'm just using it just to mop up the paint now. And that's just a basic painty layer down on the grey board side. I'm now going to go in with a stencil to add a little bit of interest to the page. I'm going to put the paint onto a spare craft mat, pick it up with my brayer, and then put it on the stencil, which is on top of the Gelli Plate. I'm going to use this big stencil because I really like this pattern and I haven't used it yet. I'm going to go in with white paint because I think this might pop quite nicely with this stencil. Brayer it to pick it up and just go over the top of the stencil with it, pressing quite firmly to get the paint to go through the stencil to give the pattern. It's the first time I've used this stencil and I really like that. And just that is quite nice. That reminds me of very old basic grey printed paper that you used to be able to get a scrapbook with. I think I'm actually going to leave that as my basic layer, and then I'll be going in later once I've done all the other pages and I've got the book in some kind of order. I will then join all the pages up with the book rings and do a bit of colour through the book to give them all continuity so it flows a little bit. At the moment I'm just doing all the pages just with random colours because I think it'll give me a nice bright book. As you can see, this side is nothing like that side. And I'll do all the pages and then I'll come back and do a bit of work on stencils through the whole book. So they're all the basic sheets Gelli Plated, and as you can see, I've used this stencil on all of them, on both sides. And now I'm going to add in stamping and other detail onto them and then make them up into the book. I'm going to do a bit of work on this sheet using a few stencils. I've decided I want to use the Word Time from the New Words series, the Leaning Man and The Cogs on this one, and probably a few other odd bits and pieces as well, but I'll see what happens along the way. I'm using a selection of paints. I'm using some fresco paints, some deco arts. It's really whatever is the right type of colour that I want, really. I want to build up a bit of a background first of all, using the cogs around the edge. So I'm mixing up mud splatter and green patina on my brush as I go. I'm going to just take this along the edge a little bit. I'm doing it with a stencil brush because I don't want it a very deep colour, and I always find I control it a little bit better with a brush. I'm now going to just go over the top with a little bit of the patina. Just to mix them up a little bit as I go. I'll do a little bit down this corner as well. Again, going in with the mud splat first. Was actually quite good. I've got some of both on my brush, and it's mixing as I'm going. That's actually giving a really nice mottled effect. Oh, that was like crafting for free because it did it itself. I'm going to have to flip the stencil. So, wipe off the wet paint and flip it. On the bottom there. Now going to use the word time. I'm going to bump the time with two colours to give it a bit of shadow, and I want my man leaning against the word time, so I'll have to be careful how I position it. So I have him leaning about there. I'm going to do him, the word time, not him, because I'm doing the word, aren't I? I'm going to do him, do the word, first of all, in white. If I can find my white paint. There's some white paint. Put a spot of that on my mat. Pick it up with my brush. And go through the word. I always used a stencil with cut and dry, but recently I've preferred to use a brush just because I find it easier to control exactly where I'm putting it, and sometimes I'd get bits of paint over the edge of the stencil where I didn't want it. See, that's the word time, and it's just really blotted out all of the black, the background. Now I'm going to take a little bit of black paint. Again, I'm using the fresco because I just like how quickly that dries. Get the stencil with a wipe so I don't get too much bleed, and put it back over the original word, and then I'm going to bump it down a little bit so I end up with the white at the top, as if the light's coming in from the top and hitting the word. Maybe my wipe wasn't quite dry, it's gone grey, but never mind. see there is just a very white fine border at the top. That probably doesn't show very well because it's on a pale background. I might just bump that with a bright white pen when I've finished. I'm going to give that a bit of a dry to make sure I don't smudge it. And I'm going to take my man. Again, I'm going to do him in black at the moment. To lean him against the eye. What is that? Yeah, just fractionally on the eye and on the M. Just go through him. Dry him. Make sure he's very, very dry. Make sure my brush is very clean. I don't want too much residue of black paint left on this. Clean the stencil, and now what I'm going to do is replace the stencil over the top of him and get the cog one and position that over him and use the brown and the green that I've got left on my mat and go over both the stencils, holding them firmly in place so they don't move. See, he's got a bit of a coggy pattern on him now. I'm going to use the edge on this time stencil again and paint, and I'm going to border around the whole page. What I'm going to do to get a consistent border is put the edge of the little circles flush up to the edge of my board book, and then I'm going to miss the tab. Let's do that. All the way around my page. Always ensuring that I can just fill the edge of the little circles when I run my finger along the edge of the page. And up here, I lined up the edge with the end of the previous bit, so you get a continuous line going all the way around. I now want to stamp a little quote up in that corner. I'm going to use black archival ink. And I want to use my story. square on this one. I don't want to stamp it direct because I want to split it. I want to have my story I will share. So I'm going to find a little scrap piece of paper. I always like to stamp on book margins because it's already old looking and it saves you having to age it. So I'm going to just stamp that on the bottom. That's handy, I can put that over that nasty smudge of paint I got down there. I can position that just over there. And I'll be sticking that in position like that. And then I'll just edge around the whole page with black paint. You can see all the completed pages on my blog, and there is a link in the comment section of this video. Thank you.